current COVID vaccines offer robust immune cells against Omicron. The Omicron is known to evade human antibodies. This contributed to the surge in new cases, despite the number of people fully vaccinated against COVID-19. However, it doesn't mean that current vaccines do nothing. A new study suggests that cellular immunity continues to protect from severe symptoms, even against Omicron's infamous evasion. Some studies found that leading mRNA vaccines could only provide limited protection against Omicron. This means that the initial more than 95% isn't the same for the variant. That explains why breakthrough cases happened worldwide. But deaths were relatively low among the vaccinated, and more so among the unvaccinated. You might be curious, how do current vaccines protect you if the variant could evade antibodies? The answer lies in the other aspect of the immune system, cellular immunity. Antibodies produced by B cells are key in controlling infections. By attaching to pathogens, antibodies can prevent invaders from capturing healthy cells. As good as that sounds, antibodies have a huge weakness, mutations. When viruses mutate, the physical structure may change. Antibodies have fixed attachment points like the teeth of a key. If the target virus has an altered structure, antibodies may not fit perfectly. This makes them less effective. At Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center, researchers found that antibodies weren't the only ones primed by COVID vaccines. Both killer and memory cells could be uplifted by vaccines to fight Delta and Omicron variants. They observed these in the samples from 47 people vaccinated with either Pfizer or Johnson & Johnson vaccines. Our data provide immunological context for the observation that current vaccines still provide robust protection against severe disease and hospitalization due to the Omicron variant, despite substantially reduced neutralizing antibody responses and increased breakthrough infection, said corresponding author Dr. Dan H. Baruch. Published in the journal Nature, the team analyzed samples for CD8+ T-cell and CD4+ T-cell responses to the original strain, Delta and Omicron. The comparison was established 1 month after vaccination and 8 months after final vaccination. Besides immune cells, samples were analyzed for neutralizing antibodies as well. Like previous studies, the cross-reactivity of antibodies wasn't impressive against the strains. Omicron could really evade vaccine-induced antibodies. But when they reviewed cellular response, the CD8+ response for Omicron was over 80% cross-reactive with the CD8+ response to the original strain. This was similar to the CD4+ response having 80% cross-reactivity. In simple terms, the vaccines could arm killer and memory cells for COVID-19. This would lower the chances of severe symptoms and hospitalization. What's your take on this new study? Do you agree that our immune cells could be lifted to fight COVID variants? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.